What's going on, guys? In this video, we're going to start working with the gin-HTTP framework by building a simple REST API. And if you want to learn data science with Python, check out DataCamp. There is a link in the description below this video. You will get certificates showing your progress, and you can include them as part of your LinkedIn profile. You can download the Golang cheat sheet. There is a link in the description below this video. Remember to subscribe to the channel, and let's get started. Okay, first, I'm going to initialize the project, go mod init, gitlab.com/pragmaticreviews/golang-gin-poc. And I'm going to install the gin library, go get, and this is github.com/gin-gonic/gin. Okay, and let's start by creating a new file. I'm going to call it server.go. The package is going to be main. And I'm going to create a main function. And here I'm going to initialize a new server using the gin library. So it's going to be equals to gin.default. This is the default server, like this. And if we go here, we're gonna see that this server is going to include, by default, a couple of middlewares. In this case, we have a logger that is going to output information about the requests. We're gonna see that in a second, and then we go back. We have this recovery function that is going to recover from any panics and is going to write the 500 HTTP code if we get any panic condition. So I'm going to close this and I'm going to keep working on the server. And let's create our first endpoint. So let's create a get endpoint, server.get. Let's call it test. And let's create an anonymous function. And here we need to pass the context. There is a special struct in gin that is the context. So we can specify it like this, ctx, and a reference to gin.context, like this. And the context includes the HTTP request, a writer that is going to be the HTTP response at the end, and a bunch of other attributes. Let's go back. And here we need to include the body of this function. We're going to return a JSON, ctx JSON. The HTTP code is going to be the first parameter. In this case, it's going to be 200. And here we can return the body of the response, gin.h, and here this is a struct, and here we can pass the JSON object. This is going to be message, and the value is going to be okay. Let's run this, go run server.go, and yeah, before running it, I forgot to initialize the server. This is going to be server.run, and we need to pass the port. That's going to be 88 in this case, let's say. Okay, now I can run the server. Yeah, I forgot to add a comma here. That was the issue. Okay, now let's run it. And as we can see here, the server is going to output some debugging text. In this case, it's saying that if we can use these two ways to change from the debug mode, that is the current mode or the default mode when we start the server. And doing this, we can switch from debug to production mode. And basically saying that it's listening on port 8080 and that this is the only endpoint available for this HTTP verb. And this is the URI. Okay, let's go to Postman. And let's run the first request, and the port is 8080 actually. Let's try this, and we get a response, and here we get a pretty nice output, including the response time. Here we have the verb, and here we have the URI. Okay, I'm going to stop this. We're going to create an entity, a service, and a controller. So let's get started by creating the entity. Let's create a new folder, entity. And I'm going to create, let's say that we want to manage video information. So it's going to be video.go. The package is going to be entity. And we are going to create our struct. Type video struct. It's going to have a title that is going to be a string, a description that's going to be a string, and a URL that's going to be a string as well. Just to keep it really simple. And here we need to specify the details for the JSON serialization. This is the JSON title. For this property, it's going to be description. And for the last one, it's going to be URL. Now I'm going to create a service. And this is going to be video service. File video service.go. The package is going to be service. And the type here, I'm going to create an interface. And I'm just going to create two functions, one to save the videos and another one to get the list of the existing videos. So this will be video service. Interface, and we save. I'm going to receive the video, and I'm going to return the new video. And the final function that is going to return a slice of videos, like that. Okay, now I'm going to create a struct that is going to implement that interface. And it's going to include as a property a slice of videos. Like that. And I'm going to create a constructor function to get a new instance of this video. And it's going to return an implementation of the interface that we created here. And here we can return a pointer to the struct. Okay, and now let's get started working on these two functions. Func. Here we need to specify the struct to make it implement the interface, like that. And the same for the final function. Okay, and we are going to use this slice to store the videos. So the final function is going to return that slice. Return service.videos. And here we are going to append the new video to the slice. So it's going to be service.videos equals to append. And I'm going to pass the slice first. And then the new element. That's going to be the video. I forgot to add the name of the argument. Like this. And this is going to return the video. Okay, and now let's start working on the controller. The controller basically is going to include all the handlers for the two HTTP verbs that we're going to handle. We're going to handle a get to get the list of existing videos and a post to create a new video. So let's create a new folder. It's going to be controller. And it's going to be video controller. That go. The package is going to be controller. And we're going to have an interface type video controller interface. And it's going to include two functions. A find all function. They're going to return a slice of videos. And a save function. In this case, we're going to receive a gin-gonic context. And we're going to use this context to access the data that comes with the HTTP request. So this is gin.context. We need to use that structure. Okay, now let's create the struct that is going to implement that interface. Let's call it controller. Okay, and this struct is going to include a service, and it's going to use that service to delegate these operations. It's going to be service, and this is service that video service. Okay, now we need to add a constructor function. It's going to be func new, and this constructor function is going to receive the service. So we need to add this argument, and this is going to return a video controller. So here we need to return this struct, and we're going to pass the service. Okay, and now let's start working on these two functions. Func, and here we need to pass the controller struct to implement the video controller interface. This is going to be a pointer to the controller struct. And the same for the save function. And this is just going to delegate to the service. So service.findAll. And here we need to declare a video variable. It's going to be of type entity.video. And we need to extract from the context the payload that is going to be a JSON, including the video struct. So ctx that bind JSON. This is the function that we need to use here, and a pointer to the variable where I'm going to unmarshal the video. And here I need to delegate to the service. Yeah, this is actually c.service.final, and here c.service.save. And we need to pass the video. And yes, I forgot to add this here in the interface, where we need to return the video every time that we store a new video. I'm going to add that here, and I'm going to return the video. Return video. Okay, really simple, just two functions. And now let's move on to the server. I'm going to remove this one, and I'm going to create another endpoint. It's going to be server.get. And this is going to be posts, and an anonymous function that is going to handle that HTTP verb. Here we need to declare the context that is a pointer to gin.context struct. And here I'm going to declare a couple of variables. The first one is going to be video service. There's going to be a service.video service. And here I need to use the constructor function. Like that. And the next one is going to be the video controller. Controller.videoController. And this will be controller.new. And I need to pass the video service here. Okay. And here within this get handler, we need to use the controller. And here we're going to use the final function. And here we need to use the context and the JSON function of the context to return this list of videos. So this is ctx.json. And we need to pass the HTTP response. That's going to be 200 in this case. And now the controller that final. And that's that. And we are going to add another HTTP verb that is going to be the post HTTP verb to create new posts. So it's going to be post. And here we need to replace this final function by the save function. And I'm going to pass the context here. And that's all I need. Okay, this is going to be videos instead of posts. Yeah, now makes sense. Okay, let's run this. Okay, now let's go to Postman and let's run a couple of requests. Yeah, the first get request is going to return an empty array. So this makes sense. And now let's create a new video. So we're going to pass the title one, desk one, and the URL, let's say https://youtube.com/ something like that. Let's run this. We get the title that we created. And if we execute the get operation, we're gonna get the element. Yeah, we get the array with the element that we just created. And let's create a couple more. And as we can see here, we have our first version, our initial version of the video API up and running. And here we can see the details with the response time, the HTTP method that we are executing, and the URI, a get, post, etc. And here we have the HTTP response here highlighted in green. Okay, guys, that's pretty much all I have for today. Thank you for watching, and I see you in the next video. Take care. Bye.